My name is James Fairfield with Point Blank Enterprises. I'm the Director of Training and Product Support, and we're here today to talk about the new holster offering from Gould & Goodrich. The Teller holster will arrive to you in a clamshell packaging. Once you take it out, we need you to confirm that the holster model and the firearm model for its intended use are a match. There are some mechanisms inside that can be damaged by compelling a holster to accept a firearm for which it's not designed. So before you mount it on your belt, we'd like to go through a few instructional steps. First of all, take a look at the holster and understand how the mechanisms are actioned. There are three defined steps in this version of the holster to allow the firearm to be removed. Your holster may or may not be equipped with this bail mechanism at the top. If it is, take a moment to index the tip or top third of your thumb on the bail mechanism and push it down to its full downward position. Once it reaches the bottom, you can then roll the bail forward and fully off the top of the firearm. The next mechanism is a thumb release lever. Once you've rolled the bail out of the way, if your holster is equipped with one, your thumb should naturally fall on top of the mechanism. Take a moment, again, before putting your firearm in it and before mounting on your belt to understand exactly what's happening as you activate these mechanisms. Once you've familiarized yourself with what's happening with the holster as you action it, we're going to take a confirmed safe and unloaded firearm, or in this case just a blue gun, and we're going to open the bail and we're going to insert the firearm into the holster body. Notice that audible click. You may actually see the thumb lever move as the spring-loaded ejection port lock engages on the firearm. You can then return the bail to the upright position. This is the fully secured orientation for the Teller holster. Take a moment to action the bail and to press the lever and understand just what needs to happen while you can see it in hand before you add it to your belt. Having familiarized yourself with the holster off the belt, it's time to put it on the gear that you're going to wear. We want to make sure that the belt that you're wearing fully fills the belt mount so that we have adequate support and so we don't fight against the retention mechanisms in the holster. So here I have a version that is available with an optic cut. And we have versions that accept lights and without lights and with optics and without optics, as well as have those variants that do not have the extra security bail. In this case, I've confirmed that this is the correct firearm model for this particular holster, and I'm going to begin to learn the drawing mechanism. So in this case, I'm going to open the bail. I've confirmed my safe and empty firearm. I'm going to transition my grip, and I'm just going to simply let the firearm drop into the holster, and I'll listen for that audible click. At this point, automatic retention has engaged. For full security, I'm going to close the bail mechanism. I'm going to repeat this process in reverse. I'm going to drive with the tip or third of my thumb down against the bail. I'm going to roll it forward, and then as I finish my shooting style grip, I'm going to stroke through the thumb lever and allow the firearm to release. I'll show it to you from another orientation. Tip the third, down, forward, then stroke through the release mechanism, and the firearm lifts from the holster. To return it to partial security, simply push it forward into the holster and let it click, and then you can return the bail to the upward position. Ultimately, it's going to be your decision as to how many repetitions you need to put into this holster before you feel comfortable carrying it on the street. We recommend you practice in both static and dynamic situations, retreating, advancing, moving laterally, starting your hand position in a variety of orientations, whether relaxed at your side or at the high shoulder, until you believe that you can hit these releases as fast as you may need to in a real-world scenario. If for some reason your primary hand becomes injured or disabled, you can remove the firearm by using your off hand. The process, while more cumbersome, can be accomplished by reaching across the body, depressing the bail, rolling it forward, actioning the thumb release, lifting the firearm from the holster, and then transitioning to a weak hand shooting posture.